real sweet flow. It's going down. Back, what's going? Wow. Cherry. Pepsi. The Rock. Fridays, you know how we do, we live. We all the way live, up NYC. It's going down, sound the chest, move back, yo, let's get it.
Motherfucking building up NYC 50th anniversary. Number one black and brown store in America for clothing, for sneakers. Yo, Lord Finesse, what's up, baby? Smitty, happy birthday. Pretty New, what's good?
With Mayor, shout out to change back.
Shout out to your mayor. Thank you for my change. Where you go? Shout out. What DJs? What DJs was here today? I know Spin King just left. Who else was here?
DJ Prime.
DJ Prime was here. Who else was here? All right, Tess, move here. So we've been giving out free food, drinks, 5-year anniversary. They said it couldn't be done. If you want the hottest shit and you from New York and you from the hood, you come here. There's nowhere else to go. Not like this. Not with white marble like this. Not smelling like this. You won't get treated like this.
What does up NYC smell like?
I'll be sure. What's up?
I want to know what up NYC smells like.
Not like this. And so we celebrating the 5th anniversary. Test move in the background. Saquon Barkley's came out. Shout out to Nike. Shout out to Jordan. All the real ones. You know who you know. You know who you is. So coming through. Know what I'm saying? Oh, this that Christian Dior cashmere shit, right? I'm going to give you pain forever. I'm going to give you pain forever. If you don't like us, you've been having a hard time. Yo, 43 Giant, my little friend, get better. And so today, of all day, Wild Cherry Pepsi, Ciroc in the building. And so today, I'm going to try to do it out here if it gets too noisy. Then I'm going to go back in the... You know what? Yo, JB, smoke down the block. God damn. Yo, can somebody tell JB to smoke down the block? Fuck.
A little to the left.
Nah, man, come on. Got it, baby. You got all the footage you want.
Oh, you good?
Yeah, I'm good.
I mean,
and so, you know, yo, listen, man. Today, 5-year anniversary. Shout out, Pretty Luke. I want to do the recap of Kanye on Drink Champs yesterday.
That was heavy.
So that's where I'm at with it. No, that's what I'm recapping. Shout out to Slime. Yo, Nori,
EFN,
biggest interview in 10 years, Kanye West. You got to understand. Hey, yo, see if they can set up the office for me to go in there because I don't think they let me. It's too loud over here, man. They're not realizing what we're doing. I'll be sure what's good. Best
Kanye
interview.
Haircut? Huh? Start with Kanye's haircut.
Kanye's haircut.
We'll start with that.
Kanye don't give a fuck. And he got $9 billion. And I don't know what you understood. Now, let me tell you guys. If you got money or don't got money, if you ain't get inspired by that interview last night on Drink Champs, you will never be inspired. You will never go nowhere. And so whether you like the man or you don't, the man come from nothing and made $9 billion. And he told you everything you need to know. Everything. They said they could hear me. All right. Yo, Fleazy, can they set up the back room? We still went to do it so I could do it in there a little bit more quiet. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, listen, man. That's what I'm going to have to do. Yes, my brother, I got it. I'm on the live with 10,000 people, brother.
I'm Young Lord's nephew.
God bless. All right?
Bring the Pepsis?
Exactly.
Yeah, they're there? Yeah, bring them.
Wild cherry Pepsi.
You got them on the table, crack.
Yeah, they're over there, but I mean, it's too loud over there, so I'm going to do it from here, yeah. But it's cool. We got it. Let's see what this is. You can't stop the rain. And so, Percy T.S., the mad blogger, is in the building.
Oh, stop.
Yeah.
No, you
got to
stop.
Yo, listen. Check this out, brothers. Percy is in the house. Let me tell you something. When I say 10,000, it's because every time we go on, we go viral with no fuck shit. And so you can have one guy on this. And when you look at all the blogs, they going to talk about this. And 10,000, I might have took it light. Let's say 1,000,000. They might keep showing this clip 1,000,000 times. You talking to the wrong guy. You can't count me out my blessings. There you go. You got that. Where's the Ciroc at? I can't see it. There you go. Okay. Ciroc. A much finer vodka. Wild cherry Pepsi. Y'all know what this is. And so what you need is inspiration. What you need is inspiration. And let me tell you something. Last night, this is the official, unofficial recap of Kanye's interview last night. And there's by far too much to talk about. Nori, EFM, interview of the last 10 years. Don't let nobody else tell you anything about nothing else. You know, this is what I do, interviews. I make a lot of money doing interviews. Too much money doing interviews. And so I know what it is. These guys bodied the game. Kanye West, the one you want to hear, the one you love, Focus. Shout out to my brother Nori. He looked so sober last night. Nefertiti Ivani, her single's out right now featuring yours truly. Summer Walker has an amazing album out right now. And so Nori was so focused on this interview. And so he turned around. Let's deal with disloyal shit, right? So I understood every single thing Kanye was saying. When you talk about John Legend, you talk about Big Sean, and Big Sean's my bro. I love Big Sean. But when you talk about John Legend, these guys, he put these guys in the game. So if you discover somebody, these guys didn't have no money. Now they're rich, they're on commercials and movies and everything, and everybody's living in mansions. And even if you disagree with the man, but the man put you on, you're never supposed to disagree with the man that put you on. If you don't agree, you stay quiet. If you don't agree, you stay quiet. And so the man says, oh, he put him in the game. Loyalty over everything. Thank you. Thank you. He spoke with clarity and spoke amazing. The man talk about he got $9 billion. The man talk $9 billion. Billion. $9 billion. I personally could not sleep. And so I'm thinking I'm getting money. I'm thinking I'm making money. But I'm broke as hell compared to this dude. And so he made $9 billion. The man said, thank you. The man said, thank you. The man said he wants to turn his brand public. Kanye West, he wants to turn Yeezy public and make $1 trillion off himself. People betting on him. Did you hear that? And he didn't talk about no beef. He said Jay-Z is his boss. They asked him about verses. And now, I don't know what people talking about. You obviously know that I call Drake the Michael Jackson of this time. But I don't know what people thinking. If there's a versus between Kanye and Drake, I don't care how much hits Drake got, how many hits Kanye got, this is going to be the battle royale. Don't get it fucked up. He does God's plan. He does Jesus walks. Lock the door. Don't get it fucked up. Sean Pecos is in the building celebrating the 5th anniversary. Wild Cherry Pepsi. Ciroc. In the building. Sleep on Ye? Bro, I watched this interview in its entirety. 3.5 hours. You know, everybody else, let's keep it real. Everybody else, they go and they try to compare, you know, other bloggers, other interviewers. Yo, the interview of the year. No, fuck that. This is what he was explaining with you. You always let your pride and your ego turn some shit into competition. Say the truth. It was the best interview in 10 years. I don't give a fuck who you call. And so, somebody did the most genius shit in the world and told my brother Nori, please don't talk too much. They would have told me the same shit. My family would have said, yo, Joe, please don't talk too much and let him talk. And not only did Kanye talked, he talked some shit and shit you couldn't believe. So the first thing that I understood, yo, big boy from L.A. was good. And the first thing, yo, Norey, hold on. Damn, how you do that? Hold on. So the first thing, yo, Norey, yo.
How you doing?
God bless you, my brother. I'm so proud of you, man.
Thank you.
And I'm gonna tell you something, right? Me and you, we built such a trust over the years. You got my back and I got your back.
Absolutely.
But I still love how I talked to you yesterday, but you didn't tell me that Kanye did drink chance.
Okay, hold on. I'm gonna tell you something. You know I'm your little homie and everything else. I'm your little homie.
So no, you my big homie in media.
In media. But yesterday I was talking to you, and we was talking about another podcast. We was talking about Smoke Champs, and I was trying to get in the word, but you was laughing so much about an incident, and we were both laughing, and then I went to the.
But Nori, I respected the silence. I respected that I don't want no bad luck. I don't want nobody to fuck this up. I want this to be the interview. Let me tell you something, Nori. This is the interview of the last 10 years. Don't let nobody tell you there's an interview close.
Right, thank you.
Nobody.
Thank you.
I don't give a fuck who you get. This man was talking, first of all, was you surprised that he was so open? And I feel like Kanye's like our conscience, but we filter what we say. We watch what we say. He say what the fuck he want to say.
Yeah, he says exactly what he wanted to say. It was crazy because how did it happen? I'm sitting on my couch, Joe, watching The Sopranos, And, you know, I used to have an ability back in the days when my beeper used to ring. I used to hear from how it rang that my beeper was money or this was a problem. You know what I'm saying? So when I heard the phone ring, I just knew, like, it rang, and then I just knew it was money. So I was falling asleep, and I looked, and it was like, yo, this is Ye. Can I speak to you? So, you know, naturally, I'm thinking someone's playing on my phone. So I'm like, who? And he's like, Ye, the artist formerly known as Kanye. I said, no, this is this guy. So he calls me, and we talked for hours at first, to tell you the truth. And then he called me the next day, and we talked for hours. And then I just hit him. Again, I hit him out of the blue, just like positive energy or something. And he said, can we record tomorrow morning, 10 a.m.? So I was like, what? And I was like, you know, I'm still thinking. So the craziest shit is we say 10 a.m. So in order for Drink Champs take 3 hours to 2 hours to set up. So literally my guys had to be there at 7 a.m. So his plan landed at 9 something. He went straight to Racket. And all my guys are sitting there scared to death looking at him. And he's like, oh, Nori's not here yet. And then he went to McDonald's. And then I arrived because he said he'll be there at 10. But I arrived at 9:20 and he was there. And I kid you not, he signed the paperwork. He just gave us his all. You know what I mean? And
let me tell you something. This man, another thing about you, man, you're so honorable, Nori, and humble.
Right.
Something I peeped there was when the man said he named his daughter after you.
Yeah,
you knew that.
I never
said it.
No, you know what's crazy? You brought me to the concert with Kanye West. I was with you, and he grabbed his... You was talking to Coley and Courtney, I believe, and Food Guard, and I was sitting to the side, and he grabbed his wife, and he grabbed her hand, and he said, this is who we named North after. And I was just like, I was honored. Like, I was like...
But you ain't tell me that night. That was an amazing show. No, you ain't tell me that. Nah, you ain't tell me that. I wouldn't.
Ask your wife. Ask my wife, you were right there. You're probably mingling, but you were right there. And that was the first time I actually heard it. And I was honored. I never, like, actually used it because, and like I said, it's out of the blue. He just called me and this happened. Word.
And so you went, EFN is on his A game.
Yes. Yeah.
You in your A game, man. You so fucking, I'm looking at, who told you, Nori, shut the fuck up?
Me.
Was it your
me.
Wife?
No, it was
me. No. Was it was Mr.
Me.
Lee?
No, it was me.
Who told it you, Nori, shut the fuck up this one?
You know why? It was the pregame. When he kept calling me, I started to realize that he really likes to hear himself talk. So I said to myself, if he likes this off camera, he gotta like it on camera. So I just let him talk. Like, I didn't know certain things that he was gonna say, like, you know, I'm answering all calls today, letting people know, like, that was his views. It wasn't my views, you know what I'm saying? But I didn't think he was gonna give it up. I didn't think he was gonna drink. I definitely didn't think he was gonna smoke. I thought he was gonna be like, you know.
Smoke champs went up. Yesterday's smoke champs is not today's smoke champs.
Yeah, so, yeah, he
smoked. Smoke champs went up.
Right. It was beautiful, Joe. It was like, you know, I remember like the Pharrell moment, the Cameron moment, you know what I'm saying? It reminded me of this, but, you know, this guy is like, this is the first time people try to bootleg.
Yeah, nothing bigger. Yo, listen, Nori.
No, listen, you know I'm trying to bootleg our episode. Like, this is the first time.
I don't lie to you. Uh-huh. I don't never lie to you. Your shit was the biggest shit in 10 years. Why? What? You can interview Drake. You can interview Kanye. You can interview Jay-Z. This man was dropping so much knowledge, bullshit, this, that. It's not your fault if he takes a shot at Talib Kweli. That's a big man.
Right.
I couldn't believe he was going there.
Right. Me neither.
With Big Sean, I couldn't believe he went there.
Let me tell you a funny thing about Big Sean. Big Sean was scheduled to come on Drink Champs the day before. And he didn't come. I don't know if he canceled. You know, Nasheen and Natanya.
Better for him that he's coming after. Because he got a lot to say now.
Yeah.
Better he's coming after. And yo, let me tell you something. I always say consistency is key. Man, you motherfuckers cracked the code. And let me tell you something. That whole internet was just you and EFN and fucking cut. What it felt like to you? When, did you look at Instagram yesterday and just seen the whole timeline was just like fucking like an earthquake? We watched it. Let me tell you something. I sat around, my daughter, my family, the mayor, the this, the that. We sat around together like 10 of us waiting for that shit to come on. Mm. Like fucking good times. Like good times was coming on or some shit like, or the Martin show with Biggie. Like we was like tuned in, tuned in, tuned in.
Right.
Did you know that he was going to give you all that? Did you know, like...
No, you know, Joe, when we book artists, we always ask them, what do they want? Like, you know, like, if you want some liquor, you want some McDonald's, you want some Missing Childs, or whatever, we always ask. That's the only artist we didn't ask what he want. You know what I'm saying? Because we didn't expect him to play the game. We didn't expect him to drink. We didn't expect him to smoke. And, like, he's really on his Black Elon Musk type of wave.
He said really, this is his peers, Jeff Bezos, Elon Musk. He's worth $9 billion. He said he's going to put himself as a human being on the stock market to make $1 trillion. He's taking himself public. Great. Not a car company, not an airplane, not a clothing line, not a liquor. He said he's taking himself.
Right. Right. That's crazy.
Public to get the tea.
Right.
And you said, what's the tea? And he said, oh, trillionaire.
Go ahead. I tell you like this, Joe. So this is the backstory that a lot of people don't know. So after the video is done, I mean, after the interview is done, he says that his flight is not till later. So he asks, can we get something to eat? So we go get something to eat with him, and we go to Prime 112. The cat is out the bag. We go to Prime 112. We go to the room upstairs, and I see the paparazzi. And so we have to go downstairs and be like, yo, this is my life. If y'all take pictures of this guy with me and the people know that he's on Drink Champs, like, this is messed up. Like, you know, like, I know the paparazzi, you know what I'm saying? So the paparazzi flew from 4 blocks away, got a picture of him, but not with me. And then the next day he lost his passport, so he wants to hang out. I bring this guy to Carbone, Fat Joe. I bring him to Carbone, and I got
you
like,
bring him to all the good spots. Why you ain't take him to ZZ's?
No, ZZ's was closed because it was a Monday. So I had to like put jackets over him because I didn't want people to see us together, because I didn't want people to put two and two together and to make four. But I tell you this, man, we just got off the phone with the Twitter live chat for The Heart of They Fall with Jay-Z and them. And one of the first questions that they asked Jay-Z, meanwhile, he's promoting his movie. And a guy comes on and says, well, Jay, did you see the Kanye West interview on Drink Champs?
The biggest kid in the world. Your N.O.
Yes.
Your N.O.
Yes.
Fuck everyone is what I'm trying to tell you. That was the biggest interview in 10 years. They're liars. These people lie. That was the biggest. I'm going to tell you, my brother, if you fuck up, I'm going to say you fucked up.
Yes.
That was the biggest shit in 10 years. These guys ain't even close.
Right.
Not, somebody got to get Drake talking wild flagrant to come close to that. Or as because me, I was inspired.
Right.
The man said he's working on becoming a trillionaire.
I got the Kanye West cut before.
I seen when you got the cut.
When Drake Nori, come, up, I seen, when Drake come up
I seen the haircut with the little holes and shit. Yo, you was on your shit, though.
I'm sitting there.
I said, oh, my God. This is the biggest shit in the world.
I was on promo mode. Yeah. When Drake come, I'm going to get the Lover Boy tattoo. You know what I'm saying?
Drake is coming. Drake is coming.
We hope so.
No. He been told you he was going to do it.
Yes, he did.
Right?
He did.
It's just a matter of now he got to come.
Right. Yep.
Your man, Big Sean, said he can't wait.
I'm
surprised he ain't there now.
Well, he did $1 million worth of game. He came to Miami and he did $1 million worth of game. At the time, he was supposed to record with us, which is a blessing because, you know, Fat Joe, we don't record 2 days in a row. So if he would have recorded, we wouldn't have been able to record Ye the next day. So it was a blessing that he canceled anyway. Word.
Man, let me tell you something. The shit was pandemonium.
Yeah.
Price
yeah.
went up is yeah. an understatement. We got to make some other shit up. So now he goes, you say, so what did Jay-Z answer about the question when they asked Jay-Z on the Twitter, what did he say?
Oh, he said he pretty much lets Ye have his own version of the truth. But he said the only thing that he did disagree with is that Just Blaze wasn't copying him. He said that Just Blaze was following the method of the album. You know what I'm saying? So what Ye said, Ye accused Just Blaze of being a copycat. He said that that Just Blaze copied everything that he did off the blueprint. And Jay, when he addressed it, he said that, you know, that's unfair because everyone was taught to make the same sound, the sampling soulful sound. So if Just Blaze did that after Kanye, it wasn't because he was copying them. It was because he was following the dynamics of the album. That's what Jay said. You know what I'm saying?
You know, we all think we them people.
Right.
You think you the guy.
Yeah.
I think I'm the guy. Yeah. Kanye think he the guy. Drake think he the guy. Jay think he the guy. And then there's the truth.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So Just Blaze, I'm going to be honest. If I have an opinion, I don't think he copied nobody because he got his own style, right?
Right.
But Kanye was on his shit.
Right.
Right? So what shocked you the most about the interview? Because maybe it was smoking the blunt. Well, what did he answer? What did he say? What? I knew he was going to say Fat Joe over Ja Rule. I knew that. You're not talking about that. Okay, Bobby? Okay. You thought somebody else was waiting for another answer. You got that fucked up. That's why I'm Cherry Pepsi, baby.
That's right.
Yo.
what was the most? Well, I guess him just being vulnerable, him just trusting me. Like, it was like, you know, most, Fat Joe, you know this, like, most of the time you do an interview with somebody, you leave, and you never see them again. It was like, you know, afterwards, you know, we not only went to Prime 112, he wanted to go shopping. So we went shopping with this guy, and he went and bought,
well,
like,
you went to Bar Harbor and all that?
No, we went to Webster, I believe, on South Beach, and he bought all of the Balenciaga. Then the next day, he took Mr. Lee and bought Mr. Lee, like, $7,000 worth of Balenciaga. And he was just vulnerable enough and just opening up to
us. He was fucking with you. Legendary.
Yeah, like he stayed with us for 2 days and we actually,
you know, when I shot the video with him, he made me buy him a $7,000 tank top.
I told him I thought it was $5,000. I told him about that.
No, $7,000. I'll give you five. I'll give you five. $5,000 tank top.
Right, right.
Like, this man's on another level.
Right.
And And I'm glad that he got the vibe with you. He didn't seem crazy to you.
He seemed
normal. Tell me about him off the camera. Like, did he seem like a normal person to you?
Actually, you know, he's a natural performer. Like, when we was in Prime 112 and we ate, like, he just started performing. Like, he pulled out his phone and he started quoting rhymes. And he was like, and it was like, it was poems, but I felt like I was in Deaf Poetry Jam. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because he was saying, like, poems that you could tell turns into a rhyme. And he was just, like, a genius. He was, like, really hanging out with Albert Einstein or something. Like, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, he had no security. So, you know, I can't allow that. I told him, I said, yo, listen, bro, you in Miami, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if anything happens to you on my watch, I can't go back to New York. I can't go back to the Bronx. I can't go back to Queens. I can't go back anywhere. So we mobbed him up. Everywhere he was at, I had, you know, all the drink champs around him, you know what I'm saying? I had everybody around him just to make sure. But it was really on some positive level, you know what I mean? Because, but what shocked me the most was, obviously the Big Sean and John Legend. That was, I didn't think.
Yeah, but we do understand loyalty.
Yes.
And we do understand loyalty.
Yeah.
And what you gotta understand, it hurts harder when you put people on.
Change their life.
You change their life and they become rich.
Right.
And then when it's time for them to hold you down. Oh, one thing I noticed about this interview is Kanye West is watching everything.
Yeah, he watches
what everybody says and yep. what everybody does. Yep. You may not think he's on Instagram. He's watching everything. Because I picked up on how he saw how Talib was talking about it. He saw how John Legend fell back from him.
Yeah, I do understand.
Yep. I do understand. I say it all the time. If we born alone, we born poor, and we get on, and we put people on and change their lives, and they don't hold you down, I'm like him. I have a problem with that.
Yeah. A lot of people agree with him this this morning. I believe the Breakfast Club did a survey about that. A lot of people called in and agree with Kanye. It's like, you know, if you change my life and you make me rich, you can have a disagreement with me, but don't make it public. You know what I'm saying? So I understand.
You know, I was watching him the whole time. And I told my daughter, I said, you know, this guy is like Jay-Z and Dame Dash together.
Yeah, he says
right? I could see the boss, the big money talk, Jay-Z. But at the same time, I could see how he thinks like Dame. And so when he start talking, he says, I'm Dame with money. I'm Jay-Z. And I'm like looking at them like, yo, I just told y'all this. And then he took a shout out to our brother Steve Rifkin, who I love to death.
Oh, yeah, I wasn't
who put me on. Steve Rifkin put me on. But you know, certain people are allowed to say whatever they want. I didn't take it like, yo, Kanye this. I'm like, yo, that's Kanye, right? But Steve Rifkin, our brother. I mean, you know, the man Kanye, he says what he says and he means it.
Yeah.
And so I'm turning around, I go, he talked about Mobb Deep.
Yeah.
See, I knew that. There's certain things we can't talk about. But anytime I hung out with Kanye West, he listens to Mobb Deep.
Right.
So I knew that, but it was crazy. You know how he gave it up to Mobb Deep? I thought that was amazing how he gave it up to Mobb Deep. And, you know, some people, it's the art of the whole shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And more than anything, I think he was giving us a blueprint to how to get money and the way he sees the world. I don't know if you were seeing that.
Nah, I was. I was.
And so he was saying, like, we all a community, we all family, even if we disagree. We just trying to tune up. Drake is actually a violin in this world of community. And I understood what he was saying. It was a lot of deep shit. And something I noticed he kept talking about was the feds. He kept talking like a boogeyman. Like, somebody want to kill me. Somebody got to kill me. Because I'm going to say what I want to say. Did you feel like he's thinking like, maybe he could get harmed in any way? Because he said it 10 times. And then he was talking about Dr. Sebi.
Yeah.
And I mean, did you pick up on that?
Nah, I think he thinks that the information that he possessed is, you know, death worthy. Like, I think that he thinks that because he's trying to, like on camera and off camera, he's talking about building a community where there's no money, like building a community where there's no cars, and it's just people that just walk around and everyone has the same amount of money. And maybe I'm interpreting it a little bit wrong, but it's something like that. And he's just thinking different. So the fact is, I think that he thinks that he can be harmed for thinking different. But I was scared. I was scared when he said that because obviously I knew.
I got real scared. You know, he's my favorite rapper forever. I got terrified because he kept saying that, and I said, damn. At one point, I said to myself, damn, yay. Like, please. Right. Like, because he feels exactly what you're saying. He talked about Bob Marley. They say Bob Marley got cancer in his toe.
Yeah.
Yep. So he's saying, yo, they trying to Bob Marley me. They trying to this, and he was speaking like it was a boogeyman on him, and so you didn't feel like that.
No, I didn't feel like that. I feel like he lives in his own world, and it's actually dope where he lives in this world. And he's a Gemini, you know what I'm saying? Like Geminis are different people. They five different people at once. And my wife is a Gemini, so I can understand, you know what I'm saying? So, but he's definitely a different dude. We definitely sat down with him for 3 hours. It's a little bit more. Some of the parts.
I know something. I don't want to make it a joke or moment. You don't want to make a joke or moment on here, right? Because I got some inside information.
I'll leave it alone.
Yo, y'all, you know now. I know the y'all. Don't do that to yourself, okay? Because you kept this quiet, but the y'all know the y'all. So you got to relax.
I got to relax. Yeah, but... Yep.
He said he called Lauren there and told her, yo, I'm the leader.
He's the leader.
And he said, well, you one of the leaders. And he said, no, I'm the leader.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, and so when I heard that phrase, the leader, you know what I thought of, right?
Yeah. I thought of the same shit.
You thought
I thought of the same shit, man.
In your mind, you like, you know, I know you feeling like you play the game. What's the name of the game you play?
Quick time with slime. Yeah.
But you was really too quick on some of the questions because you thought he would leave at any moment. You want to get everything out of him. Yeah. I know why. You was like, this and that. And I wish we would have let him talk. And I respect, I love that you even brought it up. But you said, Biggie a pun. So he said, for me, it's Biggie, but pun's an evil genius. And then you went, I wish he would have had a little more breathing so he could explain, you know, what pun meant to him or whatever. Right. But, yo, Nori, let me tell you something. Me and you had a conversation about a lot of money. Mm-hmm. And when I tell you that the price went up on that thing me and you talked about.
No.
Yo, don't let me lie to you. Don't let nobody lie to you. I'm telling you, whatever you thought is double.
Thank you, I'm telling you.
Whatever you thought, it's double.
It's
because it was the most genius interview in 10 fucking years. Shout out Kid Capri. And all you had to really do was feed him a little something and stay out his way.
Yeah, that's it. I learned to let other people talk. You know what I'm saying? I learned that from my wife telling me that. I learned that from your wife telling you that. And I learned that that's not life. That's actually in work. Sometimes you gotta let some people share. And the crazy thing is, I don't know if you've seen, at one point in the interview, I tried to stop him and I was like, you know what? You're gonna say something else genius. I just stopped because like I was shocked and a lot of people don't know. Like I'm saying this humble, but he really wanted to get this off his chest. Everything he said, like I didn't really beat it out of him. I didn't, you know, twist his arm. I didn't give him multiple drinks. He drank a little bit. Don't get it twisted. He did drink some Japanese whiskey. He did drink some Hennessy, and he smoked two or three blunts. Two or three hits. Excuse me. But
you know, yeah, he smoked with him. Smoke Champs brand went up. The stocks in the Smoke Champs went through the roof. He puffed the blunt with him and all that. But let me say something, right? And I agree with him. Yo, I really understand Kanye West to the highest level. Yeah. Right? I do. Right?
Uh-huh.
So when I turn on, he just wants to be free.
Yeah.
He wants to be a free black man who's able to think how he wants to think, not manipulated, not doing what everybody else want to do.
Right.
He knows what he's doing, and that's that. So he wants like a mental freedom.
Right.
And financial freedom, he gained that. Because what he's saying is, you ask him about contracts, he say something I say. Right?
Yeah.
We might be perfect at rap. Like, I'm perfect at rapping. Right. Obviously, I went to jail for taxes. I'm not good at accounting.
Right?
And so everybody's not the best at every single position.
Right.
And so people walk around here, they might be smart. They might be talented, but you do not know everything. Right? And so what happened is the man is saying, yo, Yala, I don't even read the contracts.
Word.
And it's the truth, though. I know somebody Kanye West hired.
Wow.
And he paid him for the year straight. The guy met him. They had a meeting. He told him, yo, let me get your wire info. The next morning, it was $3 million in the guy's account for the whole year. Wow. This is a big-time guy. I'll tell you the name off the thing.
Yeah, no problem.
Exactly what he told you on the interview. Yo, I don't even, so I don't care about Charv. Like, so if I'm going to hire somebody, if it's $300,000 or what, I throw it in your Charv. You know, he's not paying you every week. You say he don't care about that shit.
Right.
He know you're going to work for him. Here's the money. And so he was saying, yo, I'm not good. I couldn't read. He's actually beyond intellectual. You know, he uses words we can't think, but I don't like to read.
Right.
I don't like to read contracts. I don't like to do math. So I let the people do it, and fuck it. I just keep working. I might be doing something right. I'm worth $9 billion.
Right.
$9 billion, and that's nothing. You're not listening. These people are not listening. Fuck nine. He's worth $9 billion. He said he's taking himself, like Joseph Cartagena. He's taking himself, human being, to the stock market and letting you go public and let you invest in him. And what he's...
Sure.
Yo, he's going to be a trillionaire, person. He said he's going to...
Is that possible? Is that even possible?
Well, he thought of it and he's going to do it. Yo,
I didn't think it was possible for a billionaire. Word. So that's a good question, Percy. Word.
Shout out to Timberland. So right. Versus.
Yeah, I like that.
Drake.
I like that. I like that a lot. You know why I like
that
a lot?
That breaks the internet.
You know why I like that a lot? It's like when Jay and Nas had their thing, there was no platform for them to actually, you know, all right, we had Battle of the Beats, big up to Angie Martinez. We had Battle of the Beats, but, you know, God bless Battle of the Beats, but Versus just seems like a global platform right now. So for them where would they take it at? I don't know, like, it got to be an ill stadium. For them to actually do it. And I believe that Drake believes that he'll win too. I believe that Kanye was not bullshitting me. Like, because I asked him, would he battle Busta? And he said he would battle Busta too. And then I asked him again off camera. I was like, yo, would you really do the verses with Drake? And he was like, of course. And so I think that's the battle that everyone wants to see. I think that's the biggest bag ever. But I think both of them are so cocky that I think both of them would do it. I think they would agree to a price and do it. It just depends on where, but I'm also hearing that they're meeting up. I'm also hearing that they're meeting up, Drake and Kanye, to really get this Larry Hoover, you know, thing situated. You know what I'm saying, through Jay Prince. So big them up. You know what I'm saying.
I am gonna say is, due to your interview, you and EFN, the Drink Champs,
right.
I left. Me, my opinion,
right.
I left thinking there will be a versus between Drake and Kanye West.
Yeah, I think they're gonna.
I never thought it would be possible.
Right.
But as of last night, I said to myself, this might go down. It sounds like these two won't back down and it'll go down.
Right. I think so. I think so. I would love to see it, you know, because that's like the two titans at the time, like, you know, at the time, like Biggie and Pac was at their premiere. Like, even, you know, Jay and Nas, they was at the premiere, but they didn't face off to each other. Jay made his record in the studio, Nas made his record in the studio. They didn't see each other face. The only people who saw face to face was KRS-One and Shan. Other than that, people weren't face to face with their battles. So this will be the first time, like, two of the top tiers. And I agree with what he said. He said this is professional rap. Like, they're at a professional rap level where everything is strategic. Everything is, you know, calculated. Like, you know, like even when he walked in, I don't know if you peeped it. He walked in, he had a hoodie on, and he looked at Drink Champ's logo, and he went to the car and changed. He changed. I never seen this before. Like, he saw he had a hoodie on, because I'm guessing he's thinking I'm going to be, like, hoodied out or whatever. And then he seen that we were, like, cool, and we had colors, and he went straight to the car, and he threw on a lime green shirt. You know what I'm saying? So he changed. But he's, like, a different dude. First off, he tried to design the Drink Champ set. It was, like, 90,000. He was like, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to do this, this, and that. I said, yo, yay, we don't need none of that. We don't need the $90,000 set where, you know, he wanted to drop from the ceiling. And, you know, we was like, yo, please, we don't need none of that. We just want you to sit down in the normal place.
And so you're nervous till he sits.
Listen, like,
you're nervous till he sits, till he comes, you like, oh, shit, it's really happening.
Yeah, but first he wanted us to go to L.A., and me and EFN, because we just missed, you know, the other interview, so me and EFN is debating. We like, yo, bro, our best work comes in our home. Our best work comes in our home in Miami, in Racket. That's our home for now. Our best work comes there. So what if we do a half-ass job in Calabasas? We don't know where we're going in California. So, you know, he called me the next day, and I begged him. I said, yo, bro, you know, the set that you want to build is beautiful. I would love to do that, but you don't have to spend no money, man. Like, just come and just, you know, just now, have a conversation.
Now that we're talking about money,
right?
Something that I loved, okay? The man's worth $9 billion.
Yes.
Something that I love is that the man said he's looking for Beanie Siegel.
I called Beanie Siegel today. I called.
Oh, you didn't have to? The whole Philly called him. Oh, you didn't have to. Every dirty dude from every corner called the nigga in 1 second. You didn't have to call Beanie Siegel. Right. You were actually the 187th guy who act like they like him that called him.
Right,
so
right.
Beanie Siegel is chilling.
Right, he's chilling.
Not bothering nobody.
Yeah.
Going about his business, paying his bills like he's paying his bills. Here comes the Elon Musk of rap and says, anybody seen Beanie? He gave me my name.
Right.
I owe him some M's.
No, but here's the crazy shit.
And I want to give it to him. Bad!
Yo, listen.
And at that point, every doodle, dinky dink, wonky wonch that Beanie Siegel ain't hear from every corner for 30 years ran to wherever he was at. I'm holding you down, Beanie. I'm holding you down, Beanie. I love you, Beanie. Beanie's the man. Yo, I got you heard?
And I wouldn't say this unless I really meant it, but the next day, like I told you, we had dinner two nights in a row, one in Prime and the next time in Carbone. So the next time in Carbone, I brought it up again because he sent it in Prime, and I wouldn't even hit Beanie if I thought he was bullshitting. And so the next day in Carbone, I go, yeah, you sure about the Beanie shit? He said, I'm serious, man. Just give me your account info. And I looked like, oh, okay, all right. I said, all
listen right. Listen to me.
Yeah.
Man like that ain't lying in front of millions of people.
I believe him.
Man like that ain't lying.
Right, but
now the only thing we might not agree on, we don't know. Maybe it's 100 grand, maybe it's 2 million, maybe it's 5 million, maybe it's 750. I don't fucking know. Something's coming in the account.
And so when
I see that, you know me, I grew up with we talked about, they talked about crabs in the barrel. He said, Jay-Z said, yo, man, the reason why crabs be fighting in the barrel, they're not supposed to be in the barrel.
That's ill.
Right?
That was ill.
So you know what I'm thinking when he says that, I'm like, woo, the old gang is back together again. When the man said he's gonna give Beanie money, let me tell you something.
It's a beautiful
thing. Me and Remy got together, she went to jail, I went to jail, we got together, we did all the way up. We threw the single release in Aces. I don't know if you remember.
Yeah, in Queens.
Tell these people to... Yo, I'm ready to send these people to... Yo, listen. This is the Fat Joe Show. If y'all don't like what y'all hearing, get the fuck off. Yeah, now, listen. Nothing. You know, these people... So I walk in there, it's wall to wall rampacked. You see, I'm coming from the struggle. All the way up comes out like 2 weeks later, Aces is rampacked. When I get to my section, it's every guy that used to be with me for 15 years that I paid their bills, took them around the world. This, they most likely shitted on me in the hood and said, Fat Joe ain't shit. Because, you know, I couldn't take care of all these guys no right. more. Because I had to get my money back up. And when I got there, they all, yo, God, yeah, God, we back. Yo, this, this, that. I remember walking out of Aces that night, grabbing Pistol Pete, and Rich Player telling them, yo, don't bring these people around me ever again in your fucking life. None of them. I don't want to see none of these niggas next. Not one. Do me the favor. Don't bring none of them around. These the people, when I was struggling, I'm walking through the streets of the Bronx and Harlem by myself. These guys all coming and they literally telling me, yo, we back. Back to you. I'm like, no, we not. Non-cypher, dog. We are not back.
Right.
I am back. We are not back. Right. And so they had their chance and they showed that they wasn't loyal. Mm-hmm. And I love that about the Beanie Sigel thing. And I'll let you go, but listen, my brother, let me tell you something. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
And you did the right thing. Everything you did was the expertise, just like the Yala knows the Yala.
Right, right.
Okay,
right.
Don't worry. You know I know the Yala, right? So you get it, right?
Right.
You know
right.
I know the Yala.
Yeah.
Oh, man, just remember me, man. Just remember me, man. When you get this big money, man, when you get this motherfucking media conglomerate shit, pun they heads up. Very big for Busta Rhymes.
Yes.
You know me, I think the world of Kanye West.
Right.
So when he says something like, yo, Busta Rhymes, he was the nicest. He had clarity every word.
He said he wanted his voice.
It makes me feel good.
Yeah. Like he said he would chop his finger off to have his voice. Like that's a beautiful thing that we take for granted. You know, all of us have beautiful voices. That's what make our raps dope, you know what I'm saying? And what makes media dope. So when I heard him say that about I think he said that about Jada Kiss too. And Busta, he said that, you know, got the illest voices. And a lot of people, that's what made Pun ill, was like how Pun used to punch in, but I couldn't tell he was punching in. It used to sound like he was just going all the way through. And especially when you got him going, dead in the middle of a little Italy, all that is voice and that's motherfucking cadence. And that's how you know, how you do it. That's what makes us who we are. If we don't got that and we can't do that, we can't be famous. We can't be stars.
Let me ask you one question. No did problem. Beanie give you the wire info?
No. I'm setting it up for Monday because I don't speak to them again. Because, you know, I kid you not, this is the first time I had to, like, really, really edit myself. Like, me and I-Rasta was literally in my crib editing every single day. I didn't trust this to go to an editing plant. I didn't trust this to go anywhere. Like, I wanted it to be inside. I was speaking to them so much that I needed a break. So I told them we're going to reconvene Monday because we got another surprise. Monday, you know what I'm saying, another surprise along with Def Jam, you know, big up to all the people at Def Jam. So we're going to either Monday or Tuesday, we'll have another announcement. So on that day, I'm going to connect them and I'm going to put them together for sure.
So you going to give him Beanie Sigel's wire?
Well, I'm going to put them on the phone. I'm going to put them on the phone, like the management or whatever, and then let them do that on their own. You know what I mean? Because Beanie's an honorable guy. Let's just be clear. When I spoke to Beans, he said, nah, I ain't looking for a handout, but what I will do is, you know, do some beats. You know, I'll take some beats or whatever. I said, do both. I told him, do both. I said, do both, Beans. But, you know, I get where you're coming from.
Muslim brothers in Philly are not doing it. They better talk to Ock real quick.
Right, right.
Get the money. Give him your wire info.
Right.
That's
right,
your brother. You gave him his name. Nah, he's worth $9 billion. He wants to show you love. And bless you. What are you talking about?
Yeah, it's dope. But he's an honorable guy. I know where he's coming from.
No, he's a great guy. And that's what we hope. And so I allude to the same lyric that Kanye alluded to. with Jay-Z when he said, we could be each other's crutches.
Right, right.
And so that's the point is, that's what it's all about. Everybody got to get in position so that we can hold each other down when we need to hold each other down.
Right.
And so the fact that, you know, Beanie Siegel could use that job right now. Like, come on, man.
We like, all can. You,
huh?
I said, we all can.
Oh, I can too. I'll give him my. You want me? You want? Can you slip Kanye West my wire? Yo, can you slip him my wire?
I'm gonna slip him mine too. Nah, but let me go.
Permission? You might as well give him a lucky top five list. Can you give him a top five? Yo, yay. His beanies, but this is my top five. Like, can you send Fat Joe somebody in this wire here? You might want to send EFN this money here. Like, yo, goddamn $9 billion. Let's go a motherfucking party.
All right. And not only that, it was like a crazy experience, Joe. Like I said, when we went to go shopping, he called the head of Balenciaga to make sure that he wanted to go to a store that had official Balenciaga. So when he walked in, like, we didn't even have to call his store. They already closed the store down. They had champagne for us, and they had a whole section for him to just try on Balenciaga clothes. It was the most amazing.
Listen to me. He ain't lying. All those
amazing
guys that worked for all the top brands started with him.
Right.
That was his crew.
Right.
When I met Kanye West, he had 20 guys with him that looked like it was all about fashion, and Virgil was there, Dauncey, this, and they all branched out and became multi-millionaires. And I can relate when he said, you know, and no taking nothing from Virgil, because me and you, maybe Virgil really would do your outfit now. Maybe after that interview, Virgil went, you know, he hits me on the DM ever since that night.
Okay.
Me and you hung out with him.
Yeah,
Virgil
yeah.
hits me on the DM all the time. What's up, my brother? You seen the new thing? But yo, after that Kanye interview, he might want to give you a tuxedo or some shit.
Nah, I'd rather, because he did hook me up. It's just I didn't go back to the Louis Vuitton store. He did try to hook me up. But I'd rather have the Virgil interview because, you know, we just had April Walker. And that's the thing is, you know, that's a part of hip hop that I haven't been able, you know, we join in with the girls. We're getting more females. We got Melissa Ford coming up and Moni Love coming up. But we're getting more females. We're trying for Lil' Kim and Foxy Brown, and we want Remy Ma, especially when Remy Ma gets off parole. But we want to be more girl-oriented, but the one thing that we haven't been able
Hold up. We on live, me and Nori right now.
Okay, what's going on, Khaled?
Y'all, we on live.
Yeah,
this is what we call star power.
Yes.
And yo, why them teeth look so great,
Khaled? They look beautiful. They
look beautiful. Them fucking teeth. My God, you have fine teeth. Seems like you have a mouthful of gold teeth. Had to find that funny. Yo, Khaled, tell our brother how incredible was his interview yesterday with Kanye West.
Oh, man, shout out to Nori. You know Nori always up to something. You know Nori always cooking. You know, you got 100 other interviews in the stash. You know Nori.
Thank you.
Nori be cooking all the time. You know that.
Thank you, my brother. Yes, I am. Yes, I am.
Mashallah. Yo, Ira, I'm going to call you later, star.
All right.
Love you, brother. And so, you know, I understand when you put people on, they get rich and this and this and that.
Yeah.
I can relate, but the man always stand next to me. He's co-signed. He don't go against me. So I understood what he was saying.
Right.
Y'all put these people on, they filthy millionaires, and they went against. That's not cool. That hurts more than
that. That shit hurts. It hurts.
My brother, I love you. Yep. I miss you. I haven't seen you in a while.
Yes, man.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you, my brother.
Most of all, I'm proud of you for everything you've done for hip-hop music.
Thank you.
You've stayed consistent. And I'm looking at the interview last night. No bullshit, not a shameless plug, but I'm going to keep it real. Japanese whiskey. I'm standing there watching it, and I said, man, I was the guinea pig for this fucking show. Yo, this is great. I was the first person.
competition on Drink Champs. Yes, like, I was the guinea pig. Like, I remember walking out of there feeling like a fucking dolphin with a hole in my head. I said, oh, no. I got rap beef with the whole planet Earth after this interview. He was asking me all type of shit. Man, I'm so proud of you. Shout out to Timberland, Swiss Beats, Versus, Nori, EFN, Kanye West, Boo. I mean, yo, you made history, man. And I know the Yalla got the Yalla, so I'm going to just leave it alone. Know what I'm saying? You don't want to give us a joke for a moment with that one yet, right?
Not yet. We might come back Monday. We might come back Monday. Yeah, we might come back Monday.
I love you, my brother. Be good.
I love you too.
I'm proud of you. Peace.
My brother. Peace.
Wow. And so there you have it. And the guy who told me earlier I wouldn't have 10,000 people on here. The joke's on you. And so I never believe you people. When you come negative on me, or you try to slide negative on, I never believe you. That's why I keep winning. Because if I would have believed the haters, I would have stopped rapping a million. I would have, listen, man, Spinatic, what's up? I don't believe these guys. And so I keep doing what I'm doing, whether you like it or not. And so that was the recap of the recap of the Drink Champs interview. And let me tell you something, man. Jealousy's a motherfucker. Pristine Jewelers on the check-in. Jealousy's a motherfucker. Control your jealousy, man. And your hate. If somebody shine, big them up. If somebody's down, give them words of inspiration. DJ Scratch, you saw how I big you up on that Versus. You were surprised as long as I know you. The way I spoke about you, you might be the greatest DJ in the earth. But I give it up. There's nothing wrong with giving it up. And so the best interview of the last 10 years goes to Nori EFM Drink Champs. I'm not taking no talk back. Shout out to Crazy Legs, Living Legend. J1s, what's up, my brother? Let your darkest moments bring your most clarity. If you go through something, you locked up, a relationship, maybe health, and you turn around and you're looking for your friends and your so-called family members, and they're nowhere to be around when you need them. Mm. They are not your people. Mm-mm.
Talk about it.
Let your darkest moments bring your most clarity. Happy birthday to Anthony Ramos, my brother. Happy birthday to Prodigy. Happy birthday to Nelly. Diddy, my business partner. The Yalla and me's getting some Yallas together. Obviously, Ciroc, the greatest vodka in the world. We've been getting Yalla together, right? So we got this TV show. By the way, this Fat Joe show is going on TV, like real primetime TV. It's a done deal, okay? Just ain't tell you where yet. Big time. Me and Diddy are partners.
Puff, not me.
Puff, not Diddy of Harlem, a.k.a. You been going live. You know I've been watching. You know I'm there while I'm watching. What you saying? We might beef with that. By the time your blog is over, Percy, we got war in the streets of New York. This guy's crazy. I'm watching him. I'm like, I'm not surprised. I'm watching it like, they know you, Loken. And so listen, God at all times, good and bad times, believe in God. Shout out to Ted Smooth. Today's the fifth anniversary of Up NYC. Our stores, Black and Brown. Our kids get Travis Scott's here. They get Off-White's here. For many years, our kids had to go downtown to get the fly shit. I changed that, and I brought it uptown. Third store opening up in the Bronx, in the middle of the South Bronx. White marble treating people like kings. Our stores is in the middle of the hoods, white marble make you feel like you in the Hamptons. Why? Because you deserve that. Shout out to my brother Jay-Z making big, big moves, trying to be the first black online betting company, meaning black and brown people been spending their money going, what my Titi Barber's on here? Where she goes up there, Uncle Dan, will she be betting
Yonkers
up
Racetrack?
Yonkers Racetrack or Atlantic City? All our people been spending their money in gambling. And finally, Jay-Z threw his hat into it. He's trying to get online betting. He's going to do so much for the community. There's a component to owning gambling things. You have to give back to charity, have to give back to the people. And who better than somebody that looks like you, that relates to you, where you from, to give you money in the right places? Empire City, they say it all out here. They know. But if you think about how many black and brown people have been gambling, I mean, from the legal spots. My father used to play poker OTB. At the OTB. From everything, we never been able to own something. So Jay-Z, once again, is being a pioneer, going on to online betting, and I think we need to support him. And anybody who's listening from New York City, politicians, whatever, that's the play. And let me tell you something. I'm tired of these politicians. Black, brown politicians. They get in position of power. And when somebody like a Jay-Z is trying to help the community and one up, it, you stand in the way of yourself from saying, all right, it's a go. No, I don't know if we can do this. I don't know. No, you got the power. You are the power. Don't wait 2,000 years. Make the move now. Make the move now. Peace, y'all. We the biggest in the game.
Nice legendary night. Yo, Kanye, $9 billion.
$9 billion. He's going to be worth a trillion.